Let's start with medical marijuana. It's been passed in some states, but not here in Tennessee yet. Where do we stand on that issue?
I think it's still going through the process right now. I don't think medical marijuana has finished yet. I think there was some momentum early on. I mean, that's a proposal by Jeremy Faison, and the House has been leading that initiative for many years. What I'll say about it is that I'm in favor of medical marijuana for those who need it. We had a panel discussion around the issue last year where we met with patients and many folks who could benefit from medical marijuana. And so I didn't know how I stood on it before, but once you listen to people who are really in pain, you know there's a need for it and a place for it.
Representative Faison has actually been on the show. He's traveled the country studying it. Mark, how did you vote? I understand the House did pass it, right, and it goes to the Senate, or is that not correct?
No, it's still in committee.
Still in committee.
It came out of the committee.
Oh, it came out of the
House committee 9-2. I'm not on that committee.
How will you vote?
How will I vote?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I'm watching it very, very closely. I'm concerned about bills such as this. The Pandora's box is when you open the floodgates, what's next? So I'm watching it very, very closely. I understand the positive parts of the medical part, but I'm not there yet, so I'm listening very closely.
Yeah, okay.
All right, on another matter, there's a lot of debate out there about undocumented immigrants, a bill that would ban them from getting in-state tuition. Is this fair?
Oh, I think definitely they should get in-state tuition. There's no doubt about it. Many of these folks were brought here involuntarily. They were brought here as children. Mm-hmm. I was talking to Representative White just a moment ago. There's more than 25,000 of these kids in the state of Tennessee. They could greatly benefit by being able to go on to higher education. The state of Tennessee could greatly benefit by getting a new student population. And these folks are Tennesseans for all intents and purposes, except for one, and that is the legal status of their parents, more or less. So yes, I'm for it.
Mark, I know you were very much behind it. In fact, you sponsored it, if I'm not mistaken. What is the pushback? And
The pushback, I've carried this bill for 4 years now. Senator Harris is right. These children were brought here at 1, 2, and 3 years of age, most of them. They're growing up in our state, and they want to go on to higher education to better their lives in the future. I see no wrong in allowing them to pay the in-state tuition rate.
What do those who are against this say to you, and how frustrating is it for you time after time?
It is frustration. I had to pull it off the calendar in the House this week because I do not have the votes in full education committee. What has happened is that the national debate around illegal immigration is so strong that it's hard for many members to want to vote on such an issue because it gets tangled up in that. I constantly try to pull it back. U.S. Congress has got to deal with that. I'm looking at Tennessee and what we need to do to protect Tennessee in the future.
Yeah.
Education.
And what's good
always
for business in Tennessee,
right,
according to
workforce
interviews
development
we've done.
And
with
according
you
to the fiscal note on this bill, we actually make more than we lose on this bill.
Right? $9 million positive fiscal note.
But the noise now,
right.
Where is the governor on that? Has he stepped in and said, because he's fiscally.
He's supporting it.
All right. Speaking of the governor, especially in light of the recent school shootings, he has okayed a school safety plan recommendations. What are your thoughts there? Is it tough enough? Is it too tough? Is it what we need right through here now?
So I think this was a missed opportunity on the part of the governor. I think there was an opportunity to show some leadership in the sense that we've seen national tragedies, both in Las Vegas and now in Florida. I think there was an opportunity to bring people together and talk about how we can make our schools safe and prevent gun violence.
So what are we missing
here? I don't think that happened here. I mean, I think the governor formed a committee. That committee was with appointees that were elected Republicans. He had no Democrats on the committee, no discussion of common sense gun reforms. We have, on our side of the aisle, we've got some legislation right now that has not been heard. We've got a bump stock bill that's going to ban bump stock.
Right.
Dwayne Thompson, who represents Cordova, is carrying that legislation. He brought in survivors of the Las Vegas massacre, the worst massacre in U.S. history. And the House.
And they were not allowed to speak.
They were not allowed to speak in the House because there's a cone of silence right now. No one wants to discuss the full range of issues because of a fear, I suspect, of alienating the NRA.
Mark White, is there another side to this as well? Was this a missed opportunity on the governor's behalf?
Well, it's a very complicated issue, as we all know. He is putting $30 million additional dollars in this year for security resource officers in our schools. But still, there are a lot of schools that just don't have the money to do this. That's why there are other bills out there about about, you know, arming the teachers. I do not see that going anywhere this year. Mm-hmm. We spent a couple hours just looking at the language of that bill. There's so many fingers to a bill like that. Is, you know, the training of the teachers, the type of gun, and all those kind of issues that you've got to work on.
One last thing very quickly here. MLK 50, the anniversary will be commemorated next week, April 4th here in Memphis, Tennessee. Yet we're still talking about monuments, statues, Confederate statues here in the state. Where do we stand on that issue as we approach this anniversary?
Well, I think the statue issues will be put to bed here soon. I don't think the state is going to take any action, punitive action, against the city of Memphis. So I don't, and we don't think those Confederate monuments are ever going back up. So I think that issue is primarily put to bed. I mean, there may be some action at the legislative level to close some loopholes, but I don't think Confederate monuments is going to be, you know, an issue going forward.
We had heard, though, that a movement to make it a felony to do what Memphis did will be pushed to the summer session. Do you think that'll go anywhere, Mark?
It may go to a summer session. I think the conversation, as Senator Harris said, has quieted down. I've had several pro-Memphis bills going through committee, and no one has challenged me at all on that. So I think we're looking good right now.
They're too busy challenging you on the in-state tuition.